Good morning, everyone. Today, we'll begin with a new chapter in geography, that is, diverse natural resources of the world. Now, as you know, natural resources themselves have been divided into two categories, biotic and abiotic resources. Biotic, the living one, and abiotic, the non-living things. Right, biotic resources are the ones which are derived from the living things, and abiotic resources are the ones which are derived from non-living things. Now, introduction. Land, soil, water are the resources which belong to abiotic resources and are the most important resources. Whereas natural vegetation and wildlife resources come under biotic resources. Either biotic or abiotic, both type of resources are exhaustible in nature. So judicial use of these resources has to be there for enhancing their longevity. Now, coming to land as a resource, land is among the most important natural resources. Land covers about 30% of the total area of the Earth's surface. 90% of the world population occupies only 30% of the land area. The remaining 70% of land is either sparsely populated or uninhabited. Land is unevenly inhabited due to various factors of land and climate, water, fertility of soil, etc. So there are various reasons. First of all, if we talk about the land cover area, right? Land cover 30% of the earth surface. 30% of the earth surface is covered by land. Now, if we talk about this 30%, now from this 30%, only 30% area of the land, right? 90% of the world population, you know, it occupies only 30% of the land area. First of all, if we talk about the geographical area of the earth, right? If you see earth, right? And if you see the continents on the earth, only 30% area is covered by land. Rest is covered by water. Now, if we talk about the population covering the land area, 90% of the world population, it resides only on the 30% of the total land available. 90% of the world population, it resides only on the 30% of the land available. Rest 70% of the land which is available, it is either sparse. You know, sparsely populated means very less populated or it is uninhabited. And why is it so? Why it is a sparsely populated or uninhabited? Because of the topography. Might be climatic conditions are not favorable. Might be, you know, water is not available. Might be the soil is not fertile and fit for agriculture. Normally, the sparsely populated or uninhabited areas are because of rugged topography, steep slopes of the mountains, low-lying areas susceptible to waterlogging, deserted areas, and thickly forested areas. Right? Understood? Now, next. The densely populated areas of the world have plains, river valleys, which have suitable land for agriculture. The availability of rich and fertile land make it suitable for living, and a huge population resides on it. Mineral richness, water resources, fertility of soil, and good topographical conditions are important. So just having a brief review, it says that, you know, if we consider the map of the earth, if we consider the globe, and if we very carefully observe the globe, we can very easily see that only 30% of the earth's surface is covered by land. Rest is covered by water. Now, if we talk about the population available, 90% of the population, it resides only on the 30% of the available land. Rest 70% of the land is uninhabited. Reason? Because that 30% of the land area, it provides suitable condition for survival. Right? It provides suitable and necessary conditions for survival. The remaining 70%, it is not suitable. Might be, you know, the climate is not suitable. Might be water is not available, or, you know, the area is more of a flood prone, or the, you know, soil is not fertile and not fit for agriculture. That is why that 70% of the area is uninhabited. And if we talk about the 30% area, it is rich in population because of the availability of rich and fertile land, right? Mineral richness and water resources. These are the factors why the 30% of the land area, right? It is 30% of the total land area is densely populated. Now, this is your homework. Make a flip book taking idea from the image. Now, this is the image, right? So, you will make a flip book taking idea from the picture depicting various biotic and abiotic resources found on this planet Earth. Also, class, if there is any query, you can raise your questions on your WhatsApp group. Thank you.